Apparently Kai Havertz is going to ask for a transfer to Chelsea. Let's see if that goes through. It would be fantastic if it did. Did anybody else get a bit of a heart attack? They were like, yes. Ambulance called. I was like, okay, guys, don't worry. We won the game. It's all good. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Blues Fans TV. I am Sophie Rose, and I'm thrilled to be doing this video today because I get to talk about another 3 points and the fact that we are third in the league. We're into the top three, and I'm so proud of the boys. You know, games are never easy in the Premier League, even though you should think we'd be winning against Crystal Palace, who are, you know, in the more bottom half of the table, but you just never know, and they've got some very good players. Zaha, for one, we'll talk about his strike in a minute. But I just thought we did really well to hold on to that game. There are lots of good points, there are lots of bad points, but I'm going to go through the 5 reasons why we won against Palace yesterday. We're going to talk about some errors, obviously, as we always do, you know, just to be constructively critical. But at the same time, credit where it's due, we held out, we got the 3 points, and obviously Arsenal drew against Leicester, so they dropped a couple of points, which is fantastic news for us. Reason one, I'm going to start with Pulisic. Now, Pulisic has really come into his own. He wasn't a favourite at the start, I think we've said this before, but he's really come into his own, you know, and that goal, although one of my mates, he's not really a mate, he's more of a person in a group chat, but said, oh, the keeper should have saved that. I don't think there's any chance of the keeper saving Pulisic's goal. He hit it with, number one, his left foot. I'm pretty sure he's right-footed. He's got a very strong left foot, which is fantastic. Instead of looking to cross in, or a lot of players, when they're on that side of the goal, or they're more towards the edge of the goal rather than in front of the goal, they try and, you know, put it in low. He banged it straight into the top corner. I don't think the keeper had any chance. It was a really fast-paced strike, and it was just a fantastic bit of initiative from him himself. We all know I love Americans, love American guys. He's making me love him even more. but a fantastic strike. And although people are slightly critical of his second half performance, I think that's only because of what he showed in the first half. And sometimes you sort of expect more than what they can do. And I think the second half is naturally going to be more difficult because Palace, you know, they didn't give up fighting. You know, that whenever we scored a goal, they were straight back in it. A lot of teams, especially bottom half of the table, I find the minute they go a goal down, they lose even more confidence. And Palace, credit to them, and credit to Roy Hodgson's team. Love Roy. I think he's really sweet and cute, but, you know, that's a conversation for another day. Stop it, Soph. They kept going. And, yeah, like I said, they've got some good players and they did worry us. So for Pulisic to get that goal, it was really vital. It was a very, very good goal from the American, and I'm sure Frank Lampard was just as thrilled as that as us Chelsea fans. In at number two then, I want to talk about Frank's substitutions. I'm not always a fan of Frank's subs. I do think sometimes he gets it wrong. I'm sure you fans can agree with me a little bit there. There's lots of debate about the starting lineup and why Jorginho hasn't been in the starting lineup for a while. But I really feel like he made substitutions at the right time. I think Billy actually gave a good game, made some very important passes, especially in the first half. But I think you could see in the second half, he was getting a little bit tired out. And, you know, he was right to bring on those subs. And when he did bring on Loftus-Cheek and Tammy, straight away a goal. Loftus-Cheek gets the assist, takes it to Tammy. And Tammy, again, uses initiative and actually takes a shot at goal, which is fantastic. You know, I feel like we've been diddly-dallying around. Anyway, messing about a lot lately. And, God save. And it was just great to see the ball, yep, straight away in the back of the net. And that's, you know, another goal for us and a fantastic goal. We'll talk about Giroud in a minute. I'm not forgetting him. But yeah, you know, I just thought his substitutions were more or less spot on. Jorginho came on with a lovely beard, as I must say. You know, he's grown a lot more hair since I last seen him. And, you know, I feel like he really made the right substitutions. I don't think that was that Billy didn't do a good job. I don't think it's that Ross Barkley didn't do a good job. I mean, there's lots of points in the game where I think if you look back at it, you see Ross getting back in to the box and defending, which is exactly what you want from your midfielders, from your forwards. You know, when you're in tough times and your defence isn't doing as well, you know, it's important to get back and defend for your team as much as it is to press forward. So I was really happy with the team selection. I was really happy with the substitutions Frank made, and I feel like he made them exactly at the right time. And credit to Ruben Loftus-Cheek as well. I've seen him getting in there and doing a bit of defending as well, standing in front of the back four. So I was really, really impressed with that as well. So Frank, amazing substitutions. Really, really happy with that. In at number three, then, I want to talk about our passing. Now, one of the things that really annoys me about a team is when you make stupid passes and give the ball away almost instantly. I don't know if you lot have seen it. The ball was going out of play and Reece James was sort of, you know, running towards the line. He sort of back kicked it into play. I think Chelsea have posted this on their Instagram, but I thought, what a fantastic, again, bit of initiative on, I keep saying initiative today, but it's true. You know, we don't always see those tricks and flicks in. And I think, especially for Reece James, he hasn't had the best couple of games since he's been put back in the side. I was actually quite surprised Frank put him back in, although I do trust his judgment most of the time. And I'm not saying he had an amazing defensive game, but I did think our passing was a lot better. I think if you see for the Willian chance as well, and the ball's crossed into him, Pulisic finds him into space. And I think that's, what do they call it, like a through ball? I love it when we pass into space and our players run to the ball, rather than looking for the player, because it sort of slows the pace of the game down. If players run into space where there's no defenders in front of them, they didn't get a shot on goal. Obviously Willian did and the keeper made a great save. But you know, there's a lot of impressive things there that I saw compared to the West Ham game, where I thought we were really uncreative. Uncreative? Is that a word? Not creative? What's wrong with my vocabulary today? Compared to the West Ham game, I thought that, you know, there was a lot to take from that. We had another 3-0 win during the week as well, and I just, you know, I was really, really impressed, and I felt like we were playing a lot more like Chelsea Football Club and not like a scared team like we did against West Ham. I felt like a lot of improvements have been made over the last week and a half, and you know, there were just some little bits like that I picked out and was super impressed with. In at number four then, I want to talk about Kepa. Now, a lot of you are going to debate on this, whether you had a good game, whether you had a bad game. It's obviously very debatable when you let in two goals. I personally don't think, and I disagree with Lawrence on this point, that you could have done anything about the Zaha strike. I think there's two things in here, or three things actually. We'll get it out of the way. If you're talking about the world's most expensive goalkeeper, 70 million, then maybe, yeah, maybe he should have saved that. But that's not really... Kepa didn't choose that price tag for himself, and he hasn't lived up to that price tag. So I'm comparing this as to the majority of goalkeepers that I can think of that probably wouldn't have saved that, unless you're talking about the top one or two based on statistics rather than price. I really don't think that you can save that. Two reasons being, number one, the pace of the strike. It was so fast. I know it doesn't look as much on the TV, but in front of Zaha as well is Zuma. Now, Zuma is hardly an acorn, okay? He's a huge, huge lad. Would have blocked Kepa's view to some degree. And it's not as if he was sort of walking the ball towards the goal. It really was a strike that he decided to take from outside the box, and it paid off. Very, very fast. Although it's a shot sort of directly at him, I think sometimes when you're dealing with a shot of that pace, even if he had have got a glove on it, I'm not sure if his hands would have been strong enough to withhold the force of the ball. So I'm going to say I don't think Kepa's at fault for that one. And again, with the second goal, I put that down to our defence. I don't put that down to Kepa. So this is sort of a point, as in, I think people are being too harsh on Kepa for this game specifically. We know he is not the best goalkeeper in the world. But I think a lot of the errors came actually from on the pitch rather than him yesterday, as well as there are other cases where we can definitely say Kepa should have done better. For instance, in the West Ham game, should have done better. But for this game, I think in the specifics, I think if you look at the second goal, the Benteke goal, Christensen's sort of slightly out of position, but more or less if you look at Dave, and they're all sort of trying hard. Reece James obviously doesn't block the cross in, and then Christensen's sort of slightly moved out of position, although he is marking. And then if you look at Dave, he is sort of meant to stay on his hand side of the pitch. And he sort of drifts in, and none of the defenders, and it's credit to all of them, none of them look behind them. And that's where Benteke is, and he's in complete space. So I would blame more Aspilicueta for that goal. I think, again, I don't think there's anything Kepa can do really about that. I think there's only one way that ball was going, that's in the goal. So yeah, this point is not really a reason why, but it's sort of a point that I wanted to make throughout the game, because I think I'm very critical of Kepa, and I'm more than happy to say he's not good enough, like I did in the game at the Olympic Park. But I feel like in this instance, this was more specific errors we made in the game, plus a wonder strike from Zaha. So yeah, I'm not going to be too harsh on Kepa in this, but that is a very, very debatable point. Some people think that he absolutely should have saved it, was shot right at him. I personally think the ball was going at spin lightning. So, you know, yeah. And we can discuss Kepa's price tag another day. Okay, and then my last point is gonna be, I'm gonna discuss Tammy and something that I think he should have done. I think it's a very, very important part of the game. I think it was picked up by Jane Redknapp and Ashley Cole when they were doing their review on Sky. And that is when he loses the ball in sort of in the midfield area, right by the line. I thought the ball was gonna go out for a second, but you know, he lost the ball. And you don't really see him running back to defend. You know, we've got our midfielders in the box, we've got our whole defence. We're trying to make sure that we don't lose these 2 points because it's crucial that we get top four this season. Top four this season for European football. And he just seems to give up a little bit. Now, I don't want to discredit him because obviously his goal, and he came on and he made an impact almost straight away. All our substitutions did. But I think when you lose the ball like that, you have got to get back as fast as you can to defend. And I think if you look at that, when they hit the post and we had a really lucky escape there, a lot of people would criticise Tammy for that, because you never know, he could have ran back and prevented that. I mean, I don't know, you know, I don't know how fast he is, but you just expect that amount of effort, and I think you demand that amount from your players. I think actually if you look back at the Spurs game, when Hugo Lloris and Son were having an argument, a lot of people say, oh no, they're not happy there. That's not the case at all. I think it's brilliant to demand from each other as a team, as well as the managers demanding from the players. And if I was the players there, I would have been, I don't want them to get into a pitch fight, obviously, but I would have been angry that he didn't track back, you know, because especially in those last few minutes of the game where you don't want to lose these last couple of points. You know, we've already dropped too many points this season in games that we really, really shouldn't have, against far inferior teams to us. And, you know, that's something I think Tammy needs to work on. You know, when you do your job at one end of the pitch, when it comes to those final few minutes, you've got to get back and defend. I'm not saying Didier Drogba was the king of that, but there were points when he did. And I'd love to think, I'm not comparing them, the two, obviously Tammy's got a long way to go before he gets that sort of title. But, you know, that's a requirement for me. And if some teams don't want their forwards to get back, fair enough. But I require that, especially if you're the person that has lost the ball and made that error, made that mistake. So that's something I would like us to improve on there. I think it's very important that the team go back and look at that, and that Frank looks at that with Tammy. And fingers crossed we can resolve that, because we don't want another heart attack moment like that. I guess, put it on my Instagram. Did anybody else get a bit of a heart attack? They were like, yes. Ambulance called. I was like, okay guys, don't worry, we won the game, it's all good. But yeah, interesting game. And overall, I think, although there's a couple of not so good points there, I feel like we're improving. I feel like team morale is up. I feel like we've got our defending actually was really good in places. It was just those Zaha, I don't think that's a defensive error at all, obviously, but I feel like the Benteke goal could have been avoided. But you know, I think the defence was a lot more solid with Zuma in the starting lineup. You might disagree with me. But yeah, I was surprised to see Christensen is still in there actually. But I suppose, you know, somebody had to come out for Zuma and they chose Rudiger. So yeah, anyway, a lot of bad points, but also I want to give credit where it's due. There were a lot of good points to that game. And I feel as if, I really feel now, like we're going to make it, like we're going to get to the top four. And if we could finish in the top three, that would be an amazing, amazing season. And what credit can we give to Frank Lampard other than our utmost? Because he's really come in with barely any resources at all and made something out of nothing. And he's playing the youngsters, playing Billy, and they're performing really well and helping us out, you know, during this hard transfer ban time. Well, for half a season anyway. Quick message on transfers then before we end the video. Apparently Kai Havertz is going to ask for a transfer to Chelsea. Let's see if that goes through. It would be fantastic if it did. I mean, it's not the most credible. It's a credible source to an extent. A lot of things this guy says are true. Ask Lawrence more about that tomorrow. But you know, it's nice to hear that Kai is favouring us. I can't see why he wouldn't want to come to Chelsea. We're a proven club to win trophies. We have a great manager who not only is doing well for Chelsea with what he's got, he also can relate to the players, being a former player himself and knowing what they need to hear, especially in this day and age, you know. I think the reason Mourinho doesn't work out in a lot of clubs now is because a lot of players have too big of egos and don't want to listen to him, as well as I think Frank probably has not a softer approach, but knows how their minds work. So he's able to get the best out of players. Anyway, comment below, let me know what you think about this video. Those are my five reasons why I think we won against Crystal Palace and a couple of other ones that could have cost us the game there. I don't know why I called it five reasons why. I should have called it five things I was impressed with slash not impressed with in the game. Anyway, see you all for the next one.